Shimmying with Nash, just fucking don't, just go for a throw and then don't throw. Just walk in a little bit and then poke with crutch medium kick or something. Walk back low strong. There's no trick to it. If you get thrown, you're walking in too much. You should only go for them. What the fuck? God, I haven't warmed up with Evil Warrior yet. Oh, got me. That was greedy, wasn't it? That was even greedier. I jabbed, but jabbing isn't enough. I probably could have punished that. Hit my jump. With my ISP speed, I have no idea. How do you play Evil Ryu? I didn't want him to be able to teleport that way that far. I let him get an autocorrect one, I'm pretty sure. Actually, I'm not sure it was. He faced right initially. I'm too impatient against this style of play. Ah, damn. I killed. I didn't see the health. I mean, I saw the health, but I didn't realize until I'd blocked the first one. I was like, wait a second. There are a lot of setups to get a fully charged Ultra 1. Any focus attack, even off a level 2 focus, he can get a fully charged Ultra 1. If you do Ultra 1 and the opponent jumps forward on reaction, trying to punish you, then they'll land on a fully charged Ultra 1. FADC, you can't get fully charged Ultra 1. That's not good enough. There's a lot of ways to land focus attack, but focus attack is the only way to land fully charged Ultra 1. That comboed. Because it was kind of hurt, I guess. Guess that was optimistic. He's always ready for the max. That was not the max at all. Take it all back. Ugh. I wanted that to hit him. Throwing air fireballs to slow down his descent. If I jump forward, I would punish that. I focused, I promise. I keep on eating all these obvious things that are, like, really easy. Shit. Oh, fuck. Didn't expect that to work. Eh. I could have canceled that to Raging Demon, but I still would have died. Yeah, I could have teleported. I didn't even think about it. Or woken up Ultra. God, why am I running Ultra 1 anyway? Ultra 2 is pretty much the same, but I would have lived in a scenario like that. I'm confident I can turn this into wins with a little bit of practice. I've played the city on PSP, yes. That came up earlier today. I'm so impatient. Oh, I could have jumped strong that for sure. That was really good. Oh fuck, it's a fireball. I could have absorbed that. So why didn't I? Oh, the red focus? What the fuck? Shit! There's a punish. I should have backdashed. That's like the one time he focused and then released. He always focuses and backdashes. I thought I would catch him. His focus game is like... it's really good. But I can't shake the feeling that he's lucky. You know what I mean? That wasn't a punish. I didn't want that. Damn. That was a cool low profile. Could have used it to land an ultra. I'm getting baited. These are like obvious setups. Or they're not obvious to me. But like, I recognize retrospectively that that air fireball is to bait me to jump. You can do double quarter circle to buffer a dash from an EX fireball, but you don't need to. It's pretty loose. It's not that hard to link the ultra to. Wake up Ultra 2 would punish it, which is what I should be picking. Wake up Ultra 1 will generally punish it, depends on how meaty it is. Shit. I'll take that trade. Oh shit, that was an ultra. Woo. He likes to focus in response to focus. That's like gimmicky, but it's good. But it's gimmicky. Because it's gimmicky, I can break it down. Oh, I didn't think that would hit. I need to stop using EX fireballs to win a fireball war retrospectively. It's not enough. There, see, like that. It's like that was lucky that he didn't release. If he released, I would have gotten a punish. And that other time he did release. It's literally just like, have you inputted it yet? Why did I lose all this health? I didn't want that jump. Ah, I thought I blocked that. That's so good. My fireball. That was greedy as hell. His playstyle is so basic, but it's good. That was such a bad jump. You see that? That was such a bad jump. I freaked out because he didn't quickstand and I lost my setup. And I, like, forgot what I did there. I should have just teleported into the corner. Retrospect, like, hindsight's 20/20. But I should have just teleported into the corner. I pick Ultra too. I'm confident I could play the focus game to a point where he couldn't win it. I had to slow down. Damn. That should have been a full combo punish from me. That sweep is so safe. I got hit by the counter hit and the follow-up throw. I did that literally because it was the one thing. I did that with a plan. It was the one thing that EX Fireball wouldn't save him. Any other time I walked in, he would do a jump back defensive, like a jump back defensive fireball to avoid leaving the ground. And if I focused, he would do EX Fireball to break my focus. But EX Fireball doesn't break red focus. Yeah. I'm using too many focus techs. Akuma's really good at winning Fireball Wars. Ugh, that hit me. I did that to bait that. Or rather, I did the hard red fireball with the express intent of beating a normal fireball that he was going to do at the same time. Bait is the wrong word. Those are the kinds of neutral jumps I should be doing. A backdash. The fuck was that trade? Oh shit. I did low strong, but it didn't hit. Oh no, I did that combo of all combos. I could have killed him with anything. That's not even a good time to red focus, honestly. You can do the 2-bar combo to just juggle. You could do the link to low strong and then just juggle the... I forgot FADC Ultra 2 and it does about the same damage for 1-bar less. It does more damage, but... Stay medium kick probably counterpokes Akuma's crouch hard kick. I can't figure out how to punish that button. I thought it was a lot more unsafe than it is. Why am I never ready for these? Look how much health I just lost. Anytime I get some counter pressure. Oh, I tried to bait it. I thought he was going to walk out, predicting the full again. But he didn't even move. He just poked. I don't even think that would have hit me if I didn't forward dash. I'm trying to play in a hurry again. I keep on not standing, I swear. It's hard Tatsu for Ryu. Ugh. Oh, that was an ultra. My execution's so bad. I'm so bad at cornering him, and I'm so bad at, like, controlling the space. He's, like, winning 100% in footsies. Yeah, except uppercut would have killed. That better not have hit me. That grabbed the recovery of Coach Medium Kick. Man, that hurts. Why didn't I just do strong? I had a guaranteed kill there. I just realized. Jump over Medium Kick, empty cancel hard Tatsu from the Medium Kick, and then from there do just crouch stab into hard Tatsu. All I had to do was jump over Medium Kick and mash hard Tatsu. The first hit's uncrouchable, and it would have done chip damage. And no autocorrect would have hit that, and if he tried to teleport away, he would have gotten hit. Damn, fuck. Ultra 1 is something I hadn't fully considered in that regard. Fuck. I can't get the range. I can't get the range. Oh shit. I got a counter hit too. That was a good teleport. That wasn't even reversal. Ah, oh, shit. Crush Medium Kick is slow. I got counter hit out of it, and then I got counter hit out of it again. I'm trying to find ranges where I can bait the normal fireball, but he keeps on not doing it. He does it a lot, it's just that I can't chase that with this character. He does it so obviously. That beat my reversal. Cool. Red focus. I'm playing Street Fighter 4 because I'm playing against Kineda. This is a rare opportunity. I could have anti-aired that. Every time you throw a fireball, you should be ready for an uppercut. Fuck, that was a full release. It could have been anyway. Why am I so bad at keeping him in the corner? Damn. It's because I focus too much. Yeah, I'm giving up ground. I don't need to. Oh, fuck. I was waiting for that for so long. Yeah. Yeah, Ultra 2 would work there. He doesn't throw fireballs when I'm in a range to jump in. And I jump in anyway, like, every time. I've got a really bad tell in this scenario. He's controlling the game, and he's putting me into a scenario where I do obvious things because I'm not used to it. Which is, like, old school good. He doesn't throw fireballs from a particular range, but I see so many fireballs that I feel like when I'm in that range, it's like, this will be the time I successfully jump in. But but he never throws fireballs from that range. I have to just walk in, like, confidently. How? Shit. Oh, I got the autocorrect reversal. It was just a bait. I thought that punished. Fuck. I lived anyway. If I teleported, I still wouldn't have been able to land an Ultra 2. But I should have teleported because it was better than dying. That didn't hit. Fuck, I threw an EX Fireball right then trying to catch a backdash, but that time he released. Every time I get into that scenario... Oh. Just lost all that health. Shit. My combo dropped, even though I hit it. Just because I picked the wrong version to cancel into, because I wasn't... It was a bad spacing. Would you tell me exactly what would happen? This isn't even that, like... I have to figure out how to break this. There's a way to break this strat. I feel like I'm right on the edge of it. I'm walking to the corner is important. The problem is I'm so bad at punishing him. The teleports are easy to punish if he's cornered. They're not easy, but they're easier. But even if I punish one, I'll theoretically... Did you do that on reaction? I'd really like to get rid of that. There we go. Like that, man. He like never releases there. If he backdashed there, it would have been a punish for me. That's the strat that just destroys Focus Kihara. That strat literally works with every character for every single setup for Focus. That's just the anti-Focus strat. If you're blocking and you backdash to level 3, it'll always punish any Focus regardless of setup. I tried to go over him. I can't believe I just did that. That didn't even punish. I did it predictably. And I put myself in the corner. Focusing will punish the sweep, but I'm never in the right place at the right time. I'm definitely doing too much focus, but I'm, like, focus is an easy counter to his focus, except it's not because I'm not doing it at the right times than he is. I need to focus these fireballs rather than blocking them. Where am I losing the white health? That's what I should be asking myself. What would happen if I just blocked all these and didn't focus them? That's not like I'm really strapped for Ultra Meter. That's like the first time. Fuck, that actually hit. Fuck! That was me trying to keep him in the corner. Ah, that was a bad button to hit there. Oh no. What have I done to myself? What do I do there? I thought that was the counter to that. I tried EX Uppercut and I missed it. I'm so bad at punishing that. F- fuck? I got a big combo opportunity there. I'm trying to watch for jumps that I can jump strong, because that'll work if Crouch Fierce doesn't. Shit. Shit. I didn't need to take that damage at all. Burn it. This puts me in the corner. Doesn't it? Yeah. It's one thing I really hate about Evil Reese Ultra 1. I mean, Ultra 2. Predicted that, still didn't do anything about it. I need to hard read it. I was trying to actually turtle him out. I can't punish that. Let's just wait. I didn't need to do anything. He's keeping it to a fireball war really well, and Akuma tends to win fireball wars against any other character with a fireball, because he has just the most fireball options. Being able to, like, neutral jump and stop yourself from landing on a fireball with your own fireball doesn't seem like much, but it's literally just one other thing he can do that I can't. Whereas otherwise, he's pretty much exactly the same as me in terms of fireball options. That worked. He drilled to use Stand Run House to escape the corner. More passive might be the way to break it. Let's try killing focus attack entirely. Oh, that was it. Let's keep that white health. White health is important. All adds up. That was a bad jump. I jumped in at a range where he could anti-air it. Let's keep that all. Whoa. Got some damage on him. Make him impatient. Oh, that. Hit me. Oh, I tried to cancel the Tatsu. Oh, I didn't want that. Fuck. Could have ultra'd there. Focus did nothing. It allowed him to escape. Ah, I wanted to hit that. Yeah. Missed my teleport. It would have gotten me killed anyway. I would have either teleported backwards, I think, into the fireball, or teleported towards him where he could have punished me. It was a bad scenario. Hit a good spot. Why is that not a true block string ever? I'll take that trade. Ah, oh, fuck. That was it. Alright, kept him in the corner. Oh. That was safe. A that that was a punish. Ah, I walked too far. I thought we already heard the input delay news ages ago. Why'd that blow up recently? What's going on there? What, like, caused that to suddenly become a thing again? Let's try regular S Ryu. Sometimes I play cleaner with this character. I like the faster crouch medium kick. Daigo says there are lots of EX fireballs. So that's what I'm going to do, damn it. There's no room for me to gimmick around. I've just got to play fair. I wonder if EX uppercut would help me. Ah. That's a terrible instinct. Ah, so obvious, retrospectively. Tried to frame trap him. Fuck! I wanted him to focus it. Oh shit. Oh. Oh yeah. That's bad, wasn't it? Mine would have beaten his, anyway. Fuck, how'd I throw that away? Alright, he got a good bait. I think he just expected me to do a medium one. Or like he messed it up. He had the right read. Oh. That's interesting. I should have walked forward. It wouldn't matter. Got him to the corner. Ah, my techs are so bad right now. That focus. Every time they implement survival, it's shitty. It's hard to punish these teleports, man. I'm really bad at it. I don't have the OS, so I just have to predict the teleport. And I'm really afraid to predict it, even though it's usually pretty obvious, because he's just doing it, like, every time. But, like, I don't know what to do about it. I can throw a hard fireball after it pretty easily, on reaction, and that'll punish it. Yeah, DPF ADC 4-dash is -5. I'm missing the punish. I'm hitting the button too early while I'm still in block stun. Or perhaps too late after I get thrown. Alright, that's a good trade for me. I can, like, win trades. If I can only get trades, that's great. That was a punish. It's so slow trying to approach him. How about I just build meter? That's the second time he's got me with that. And not the second, it's more like the third. Oh. I thought I was being unpredictable. But it was the bad kind of unpredictable. Literally, like, survival exists for no one, I feel like. He always backdashes. Why is that? Slow on my punish. I'll take that. That's alright. Just don't lose, that's all. If I can win without burning bar, that'd be great. How is this possible? Why did you pick that normal of all normals? That really didn't do that much damage until the throw. Shit. I had to combo with the EX there anyway. Damn. It's ready to super a teleport if you teleport it out from before the block, but not after. Oh shit. That was it. Ah, that was it. 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 How'd I throw it away like that? I got a lucky jump in. He didn't anti-air me. He should have killed me. I shouldn't have even had the jump in. But I had the jump in, and I had a link combo to kill, and I did jab strong, and my strong was too early. Oh, that stings. Oh, man. Even if I just did a combo into super, that would have been good. Like, I didn't need a link there at all. I could have just done, like, crouch, jab, fireball, super. Could have just done crouch, jab, to fireball. That was bad. I'm, like, in this horrible spot where I'm, like, kind of halfway between punishing a teleport and not. What was that? I thought it was a teleport, but it wasn't. Oh, shit. These focuses aren't doing me any favors. Is that a combo? Why'd I do EX? The fuck was I thinking? Oh, Street Fighter 5 tech. You should jump on the opponent's wake up. I was looking for an Ultra 1 to throw in the exact opposite direction, hoping for a teleport. Oh, but if he teched the throw, that was fine too. These focuses aren't doing me anything. It was a Tatsu, but it was too late anyway. That's not what I wanted. I need jumping. That ultra. I didn't want it like that. That was nice. Get pushed back to full screen, and then jump in. But. Alright. Shit! What a bad fireball! I was sitting on the life lead. Jump back jab was all I needed. At least I managed to not burn that much far. Shit. He didn't teleport that time. The more health is helping me a lot. The red fireball was a crutch. It wasn't doing anything. It would get me like an occasional connect and then get me to eat a jumping combo as well. Hard Tatsu is good against his red fireball, even though it's a really big guess against his normal fireball. It's like reliable against this red one if I'm close enough. It's good enough that like I can get it even if I did it really early. Even if I did it really early was completely the wrong thing to say. Fuck. I keep on not blocking that on reaction. I didn't want that. I wanted hard Tatsu. And the Siren House was a hard Tatsu. Oh fuck, that's an ultra again. I keep on fucking it up. That's frustrating. Ah. Eh, I missed my link. It was really far. What does he need the ultra? Fuck, that was supposed to be a ninja jump. I just messed it up. That counter hit. Alright. He likes to backdash there. That's so bad. Why'd I do that? He even got the crutching. Attacked! Ugh, that was an ultra. I'm bad. I burned extra bar to do nothing. Damn! Why can I not get true block strings? Why am I consistently really bad at that? I should have done it. I got a reversal something, but it wasn't EX. He could have timed his after mine, but I should have tested him too. But if he does his later than mine, then his should win, and if I do mine later than his, then mine should win. I think. I don't know. Ryu's might just have more invincibility in general. These failed up ultras. I'm getting up forward. I'm not getting the right up directions. This controller might finally be biting the dust. The teleports are so obvious, but I'm so bad. Oh, I thought that punished it round start. Guess that's go. Fuck. You didn't have the meter. What version was that? Whatever I could have ultra'd there. That was bad, wasn't it? I'm too hungry. That was ninja jump strong. Medium uppercut should beat that. He doesn't do anything there. If I ever actually catch him blocking, that was kind of nice. These quick stands are not doing anything for me. Got me. Damn it. I didn't want that. Oh, I'm lucky to be alive. See, that EX fireball didn't really do that much. I got myself screen position, but did I need it? I can't neutral jump. I can't jump forward on these neutral jumps. I don't know what to do about that. Like, what if he just does that? What if he just throws an EX air fireball on my fireball? Like, granted, he doesn't have an infinite amount of meter. That was a punish. That helps. Damn. That's bad. This is like unwinnable territory. Isn't that bar? Fuck, I didn't want that. I wanted EX Fireball. The corner's great for Ryu, but it's not that I'm not trying to push him to the corner, it's just I'm struggle keeping him there. The teleport was obvious, but I don't know what to do to stop it, but bar, like, just predictive hard Tatsu. Like, it's always obvious. It's literally always obvious, but I don't know how to punish it besides predictive hard Tatsu. I don't have that option select. I only have that option select after sweep. He won't teleport if I'm in a range where I can neutral jump and then throw a teleport. He's just not going to do it. Any range where I can actually punish it, he won't. He has no pressure on him to do it. That was a good autocorrect. Too often I'm going for resets by jump forward at ranges where they're hard to anti-air, but that's just a gimmick. Gotcha. That time he did the backdash. That just grabs crouching opponents, doesn't it? I just didn't know the mechanic behind that. I did low strong there and it grabbed the low strong. I have to get him to the corner. That's important. Oh shit. Not what I should have done. Damn. It's not even a gamble though. The thing is, even if I predict it with the hard Tatsu on paper, I just hit him with the hard Tatsu. I hit him with the last hit and that is like 140 or whatever. And then he's out of the corner. That's not much of a gamble. I have to win regardless of the corner, as long as he's using the teleport that, like, crazily. That's supposed to be crouch fierce. I did crouch jab as well, just because I... I waited so long. Fuck. That time I tried to predict the teleport, but he just did wake up throw. The corner doesn't do anything unless I move closer. And if I move closer, then I lose the ability to punish teleports with anything but Tatsu or Super. I gotta watch Daigo play this matchup. Fuck, that was it. That was the medium uppercut I needed. I'd have done a lot of white health, and I would have done the damage of the uppercut. Ah. He risks a lot to do that, and I can punish it just by doing crutch medium kick Tatsu. Damn. I'm trying to predict teleports, but now he's just not doing them. Ah, damn it. I tried. I had to do that sooner. How'd that even hit? I thought I was still in the fireball immune frames. What the fuck? Make it go away. That's a good bait. That'd get me every time. Milo short. Fuck, that was a fireball. I always throw a fireball there, don't I? Ah, damn it. It's not the time to look for a jump. I can't win this matchup. Man, this sucks. He's good enough that I can't beat him with any character except the character he just has an excuse for losing to. I'm gonna go back to playing Guile. I'll try to out-turtle him. I'll just let him teleport anytime he wants to teleport. I don't give a fuck. I'll win through chip damage. That's bad. That was a punish. Shit. Oh, fuck. I guess he wouldn't go for anything there, because that's the end of his string. Oh, damn it. I thought that... Yeah, I tried Ken. My Ken is really out of practice. I don't have a Dudley. I've, like, never played Dudley in any BEF event. That all comboed. I was almost certain it was going to be out of range. Guile's only answer to focus is... Oh, I tried to jump. I think that was a punish, right? Damn, too early. Ugh, I didn't want to jump back. I wanted to jump up. Just take it real slow. Oh, I thought it was the light one. I thought he was going to do two. Damn, this is so hard to predict. Ugh, that was a second EX boom. Yeah, have I shut down... I think I'm focusing too much on approaching when I should focus more on defense. And I was doing that with Ryu as well, and Evil Ryu as well. I think that I just have to not... I have to just not take as much damage as he does. It's not that hard to avoid chip, but I'm taking a lot because of minor errors. But as long as I avoid chip, then I can like play 100% of my game just taking damage or dealing damage when he tries to go in. But I do need to get a life lead at some point, which is going to be easier said than done. That was it. That was a good normal boom on his part, or normal fireball. How's he always out of range? Why does his backdash go so far? Damn. Never a fireball when I'm in that range. Damn, I'm so bad. I just jump in, like, I'm so afraid. I didn't want that. Try to ultra. Fuck. I staked it all on that. That's the only health. Oh shit. I can't keep up in chip. He He waits. He just waits. I'm that obvious. I just... My question isn't whether I'm going to do it, it's just when. That's why I'm getting broken. Even when I'm 100% sure of what he's going to do, I'm never quite ready. He made me land on a fireball. That was bad. That was an ultra. That was also an ultra, but I didn't have time. Why is there this idea that five just completely invalidates four? Why is that like a sentiment that exists? Why do people like that question ask that question? Not people like that, but why do people ask that question? Why do people ask questions like that? That's what I was trying to say. Several people come in every time to ask that. It's like shit, because I want to play four. They're different games. Maybe I want to play this guy. That red fireball is such a problem. I haven't... What do you mean switch to 5 pretty soon? I played 5. I made all the fucking bread and butter tutorial videos for 5. What do you mean switch to it pretty soon? Like, I haven't switched to it yet. What does switch to it mean? Ah, oh, fuck. Reacting to red fireball with jump is... Fuck. It would be good if he wasn't doing it from such a huge range. He can, like, reaction anti-air me. I just went for it. He didn't even punish. Oh, I can't believe I just did that. 8 seconds left. That was such a huge risk I didn't need to take. I was playing King of Fighters 13 yesterday, and not a single person asked me why I was playing that and not Street Fighter 5. Pretty recently, I was playing Third Strike, and not a single person asked me why I was playing that and not Street Fighter 5. Damn. I literally never let go of down back. I don't know what I'm supposed to do about that. Jump out? Why is it? That's a really good mix-up. I didn't know that he had that mix-up. I could have gotten anti-aired there. I think I could have flash kicked those. I didn't want that. That focus tech was awful. I've got him where I need to get him in order to win. Ah, but I can't stop that. I can't believe that just worked. Oh my god. Why'd I just do that? Where'd that dizzy come from? You guys see that? Out of fucking nowhere. Yeah, they're longer than the entire jump, but I have to jump after I see them. And I also have to jump and not land on them. So I have to wait until they get past a certain point if I want to jump forward. So if he does them full screen, I have to wait before I can jump over them. I have to wait for them to come out. I did not sense that dizzy at all. I know this character has really bad Okay. That tech. Aw, damn it. Just feeling myself a little too hard. Look at that, I just invalidated, like, most of what I was doing. Damn, I don't have my minimum charge times in mind. Again! I wait! It's not a good wait. Did I get him? I don't think so. It was way too far. I need that to win. Shit. Damn. I was trying to catch, I don't know what, a sweep? Something. Just a button press. I got that combo. Ah, crouch blocked. Trying to maximize my charge time. I was supposed to be jump back air throw. I didn't want that. I didn't want the flash kick. I think I recovered in time to block that. Where did my life go? Shit! Was I that obvious? Normal Sonic Boom I would have recovered in time, but I wouldn't have been able to anti-air him. I'm not good enough with any character except Elena. It's just the flat out of it. I'm gonna play Elena some more. EX Flash Kick, it's like, if I only get the second hit, that's not enough. I need to have the first hit, or else I'll get hit before my invincibility. If I hit him during the first hit, I'll have invincibility. He can punish that. He doesn't know. That normally punishes. Damn. Ah. Didn't even try to punish it. He has terrible matchup knowledge in this fight against Elena. But like, even with all the matchup knowledge, he's still losing he's losing on more than just like the errors. There's a lot of stuff where it's like 50-50s that he's losing as well. What the fuck was I doing 5-4? I tried. Damn, I think he got me. Yeah. I've never seen that stuff in my life. It's kinda cool. That was a good comeback. The way he baited that neutral jump and the punish for the neutral jump. Elena has no way to change her midair. I wanted slide. I just buffered DP on accident. I burned bar to do that. No, I didn't. I guess it. I heard the bar burning noise, but I still have full meter. Blocking the overheads. If he's holding up back once he blocks on normal, then he opens himself up to Link's tails. And he probably doesn't have the wherewithal to punish Link's tails, because almost no players do, even the ones who know the matchup. I don't think I've ever gotten punished reliably by anything by using... I'm not sure the last time I've gotten punished for using light or medium Link's tail. Pretty much every time I do them, I get away with it. Even, like, players who play me all the time and players who, like... I know, I agree. Let's say from that range. That was cool that he comboed off of that. Damn, I didn't even have the bar. The bar makes that a lot faster. I blame lag. Ow. If I blocked that, that would have been a punish. He probably would have FADC'd it on... hit. No, he hit it. What am I talking about? Safe. Damn. I'm reverting to old bad habits. I've, like, developed. I have, like, a better understanding of how to fight him than earlier. It's lagging. Like, a lot. It was, like, huge spike. Wow, that was a failed input. Mine is really weak to comebacks, but she's also very capable of them. Oh. I had to think about all of my normals there. I needed something that came out really fast and went really far. Because if I didn't hit him on my way down, then I was going to get grabbed. That's a pretty interesting punish. What the fuck was that? Ah, just out of range. Yeah, I knew it. Oh fuck, that was tricky. Damn, that would have been nice. He really just let me full heal. That might have been a punish. And he didn't block the overhead. That's the slowest one, too. He's not even blocking the slowest one. It was not a reset attempt, I just missed my... You have to do a really early uppercut there, and I usually do it by negative edge, and then double tap, but I missed my second tap. So my negative edge was too early, and my second tap was too late. I rarely drop that, but I dropped it that time. EX, spin scythe, light uppercut, EX uppercut was the combo I was attempting. Ultra 1 is not really any worse than Ultra 2 in this matchup. Damn. Didn't want that. My cancel made me taller. Damn it. He missed his link, but then he reset. I'm glad that hit. That was nice. He's blocking reliably now, but he's not punishing. Ah, that's nice. I should have got myself the full heal. I was really greedy there. I literally just wanted to see if I could bait him to do something, but if he did immediate ultra, it was going to punish me. But like nothing else he did there would have reached me in time. Didn't want that. Wow. Damn. Why is that so effective? That was a nice bait. I wonder if he even knows how fast that is. Ugh. Mallet Smash got hit. I never use Hard Punch for the Elena. Elena's Hard Punch is a fucking... It's an ideal. It's so impractical in every sense. You can't land it after a focus attack, except some characters on a fully charged one. On the recovery of a lot of attacks, the opponent naturally dips to below the hitbox. Like, if I do Stand Fierce at the wrong time, it punishes... Like, it fails to punish... You can uppercut the EX Mallet Smash. It's minus 5 for the EX, but the hard one's minus 1. And those are the only two I ever use. Those are normal I pick deliberately for that scenario. Damn. I was supposed to be cancelled, but you know. I was so scared. I didn't want that. Does he know when it ends? Yeah, didn't matter. That was supposed to be EX uppercut off ADC. But I did too much mashing. So many people are coming in here and just bitching that I'm playing Street Fighter 4. I've never gotten this before. I got a negative edge medium uppercut there. Missed that. I'm glad I got that. That's one frame. I got a counter hit though, so it was two. Low short to low jab. Is it just going to be impossible? Is this why Street Fighter 4 died? Is it because literally every time someone plays it, there's some guy who just pops in and is like, why are you playing it? Did Capcom just like fucking... Did a game just die out of guilting? It's the battle of the century. Fight! I still really like watching this game be played, and I'm sad that, like, people have completely, like, gone off it. That's the good response, and that's something I have absolutely no idea what to do with. That was a cross-up. He recovered in time. I'm really surprised. He got reversal and it was still not in time. It's just, it doesn't work. He doesn't know how to recognize when it's available and when it's not. Yet. He's trying to jump out. What kind of character does he think I'm playing? Why was my block string bad enough that he can just hold up? This is the second time I'm playing Street Fighter 4 since February. Elena's not that bad. There are like three characters who can complain about Elena. I don't know why everyone else does. If you play Guile, then you have every right to complain about Elena ruining the game. Could have. I didn't want that. Should've just smashed it. What was the harm? Jump back jab would've been better. Linus, like, actual counterpick matchups are, like, very few and far between. Linus almost never a counterpick. Elena came second in Evo, that's kind of a big deal. I didn't even go for the link, I went for the reset. But I threw him too late, I guess. I tried to walk and throw. That was really greedy of me. I don't need to do half the things I'm doing. Ah, I can't believe that didn't hit. That was kind of lucky on his part. That hit the recovery. EX upper is what I should have done there. That gives me a lot of time to combo. EX is like a terrible thing to do. The worst thing you can do to yourself there is to act like you have a punish when you don't. Try to walk under it. Didn't punish it. I built the meter too late. Huh. I went low every single time. The second one I thought I was going to get the bar in time. I'm really surprised I didn't. Crouching short is one of the biggest errors people make when watching Elena gameplay. That button that she kicks you really far on the ground is her crouching jab, and you don't need to block it low. In fact, Elena's low game is a lot better. It's a lot worse than people usually give it credit for. She's got instant lows, but they're either very unsafe or very hard to do anything from. So people tend to have... they tend to crouch tech a lot more than they should. I got a full heal because I knew he wouldn't try for a Raging Demon. This is still bad. I didn't want that. That was greedy, wasn't it? Nice. People tend to down back because they see low kicks, and then they tend to eat overheads. At least I get to show off that I know a shit ton about the juggle mechanics of this game. That's always nice. Damn, I didn't want the release. I wanted him to hit me. He didn't. That was kind of good. He moved out of the FADC range. Kuma's dizzy, though. Kineda's points seem to indicate that he plays a lot locally, and not a lot online. And if you play only locally, then you don't have a good selection. Damn, that was bad, wasn't it? Oh, I let myself get reset. I was like so sure he was just going to combo me. I don't know what to do about that. I don't know what to do about that. That felt like really bad. That was... I should know better than that, honestly. That dropped twice. And I just did a non-EX one as a reversal. He probably thinks that works now. I probably showed it to him in a time, and now he's gonna like be like, "Oh, that's she has a non-EX reversal option." That was some bull. I accidentally went like 2 pixels too far backwards, so my Rhinohorn missed. I mean, my Lynx Tail. Ah, Toto. No, what the hell? I'm too obvious. I should literally never EX uppercut. It's too precious. I'd rather just eat the wake up mix up. He really is not anti-air me. Kuma's a dick. His defense against certain attacks is ridiculously poor. And his defense against other attacks is good enough. Damn. Thank God for empty cancels. That heals about 150 health. That was like a fully charged stocked ultra too. Got me. Woo, Elena! I calculated that range very carefully. I could be making content for sure, you can right now, but instead I'm running sets. But the same could be said for him. That's an interesting thing. I like actually want to stop pretty soon. I've been playing a lot. It's 2 a.m. I could literally just tell you right now everything that's punishable. Any version of Link's Tail that's not F80 seed. Oh, Kineda does nothing. Kineda does nothing. El Fuerte is not a counter pick. El Fuerte has pre-built holes into his focus, into his meta. Elena can just exploit those pre-built holes. The problem with Elena is that she has no tools to create holes. The idea would no, I don't want to play some games. I had to do one jab there because, it was out of range for two, I think. Elena might have no good way out of that. I can always uppercut it. I'm playing games all day. He actually got into the unsafe range, and I missed it. I guess I'll heal. Damn. Woo! I'm the best! Her uppercut's 3 frames. Pretty fast. And it was going to chip out. There's no human way that my uppercut beat your uppercut. You just didn't get your uppercut out in time. My uppercut doesn't have invincibility. EX Rhino Horn's pretty minus. If you block it. If you don't block it, it whiffs pretty quick. If you do block it, you can punish it with, like, anything. Stand Fierce. Low Strong is more consistent, I guess, if you want speed. Actually, are they the same speed? I'm really bad about that. I should use the focus as a way to get in. Ah. Broke the pot. How many normals was that? Damn. My jab! I'm not even trying to tech now, I'm just jabbing. I always feel like a baller when I get that link because it's really hard. He did it. I need the heal. Oh my god. Yeah. I shouldn't have burned it. Backdash was my best option there. I had a hit there that I could have cancelled to uppercut. I've softened. I used to look for stuff like that all the time. I'm honestly insanely impressed with how many links I'm hitting. I have no business hitting as many links as I am, being this out of practice. But I'm getting links like crazy. And the thing is, I was playing Ken and Guile earlier to warm up, and I was missing their links like every time. That's a counter to focus if I have time to get it out, but it's kind of bad to get out in footsies. I have to uppercut that. That was a punish. He's jumping out so much. I'm normally much better at stopping jump out. Nah, that was bad. Let's just focus on winning. He did a jump. I thought it was going to cross up, but it didn't. Super cancel actually would have won that. That's good too. That super does very little chip before it stops being a true block string. It does 2 ticks of chip damage, and not very much on either tick. And then it starts being... you can interrupt it. People tend to block a lot of it, though. But if he would have been just mashing uppercut. But I did all the damage I needed to. I had an opportunity to kill him sooner. That jump. That missed a hit, but not a hit I care about. Ooh, the whiff. His focus games are really on point. God, I remember when Sakura Super was the chip move of the game. I forgot that. Yeah, I canceled it, but I was trying to do... Too late? I haven't had that mistake in a while. Aw, damn. That's really clever. That time I had a lot more time to hit a button. This is gonna be my last one, because I'm just tired. I'm not tired! I wanna stay up! I wanna stay up and play Mega Man. I'm kinda manic, because, I feel like I've been working for like a really long time, and I had a really bad, stressful week. And now I've got 2 days off. And I just want to do nothing. I want to make videos. I want to be left alone. I really want to be left alone. That's what I want. Most introverted thing I've ever said. Just kidding. Not even close. Still, Elena wins so much in incidental connects. It's like two things happen at the same time, and Elena wins. Yeah. That was good. He's good. Again, I canceled it when I shouldn't have. I can react to a fireball with that, but it's really not worth it. I, like, lose the same amount of health that I get. Again, I actually heard myself. I heard the meter burn noise. I've been so consistent with my EX Malice Smashes. Imagine if I was this consistent during Bath Cups. Good connection on his part. That was a good autocorrect. Elena has a very tricky... Oh, that was a cross-up. It's almost impossible to make that go through a fireball. I really thought that it would be enough. Like the recovery from the lightning and from the fireball. Alright, that's a good one to go out on. I really thought that I would get time for a fake one and I could bait that and jump out. I was like sure of it. But no.